gathered here and finally this morning. Someone is a divine power. There is divine purpose. Don't whine and pull your hair. God is working behind the scenes. But finally this morning, there is divine presence. Somebody say divine presence. Why you could stand firm through fiery trials? Because you have the grace of God, the power of the Holy Spirit. As you connect with God through prayer, amen. You have the power of God working through you to help you through the situation. You understand when you face this thing and you want to give up. You remember Pastor words. You remember Peter words. You remember Paul words. Amen. That God's grace is sufficient for you. Amen. That there is purpose. But I want you to know finally that God has never given you a test. Amen. Because you wanted to fail. Whenever God gives you a test, He's right there with you. Can I hear amen, somebody? Just as in the SCA, amen. When they give you a test, amen. You have the people right there. When I'm watching to make sure you don't cheat. Are you with me? When they're watching and they monitor you, I hear everybody. But when God gives you a test, amen, He's right there. Are you with me? Come on, are you with me? The Apostle Peter says in 1 Peter 4:19, therefore, let those who suffer according to the will of God commit their souls to Him in doing good. As what kind of God is He? What kind of creator, church? He's not an unfaithful creator, but commit your soul, commit your problem, commit your troubles to Him who is a faithful creator. Somebody say divine presence. Give somebody a high ten and tell them God is with you. You might feel this morning that God is with you. You feel everybody abandoned you. You feel alone. But I've come to tell you that God, your creator, He is faithful. And He's going to be with you in the midst of your difficulties and trial. There were three Hebrew boys. He hot the fire 7 times hotter than it's normal. He can remain. And they throw the three Hebrew boys, amen, into the burning fiery furnace. And the Bible says when Nebuchadnezzar sat on his high throne and he looked into the fiery furnace, he asked his soldiers how much men they throw. They said, we throw three. He said, no, look again. He said, because I see four. And four looks like the Son of God. When you're going through a trial, you have a faithful creator. You are not alone, because God Almighty, He's your vanguard. He's your rear guard. He goes with you. He goes before you and He goes behind you. For David says, surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Tell somebody, God is with you. He reminds the saints that they can stand firm, they can get through this, because why? You have divine power, you have divine purpose in this trial, but God is with you. Tell somebody, God is with you. And the Bible says, commit your souls. Commit your soul. That word commit your soul in the Greek means it means to place something in the care of another. Commit your soul means to commit what is important to you, or to place something in the care of another. When you are going through a situation this morning, you can't. Let me tell you something I don't know about God's hands. Everyone, take out your hands. Watch your hands. Take out your both hands and watch it. I have news for you. Your hands are real small. And you can't handle what you're going through right now. Are you hearing me? Your hands real small. You can't even handle your husband that God gave you. Or the wife. Take those hands and get close to your husband. And just lay it on them. My God. I'm going to make a special call for married couples after this. Hold the hands are still laying here. Your hands small. Look at your hands. Look at your hands. And what you are going through, your hands are incapable of handling what you're going through. The Apostle Peter, because he knew, like you and I know from experiments and learned about God's hands, God's hands humongous. Amen. 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 The Bible says, He's got the whole world in His hands. He's got the whole wide world in His hands. He's got the whole world in His hands. He's got the whole world in His hands. He's got, all right, no, no, no. Well, listen, you got me, brother. Amen. But I want you to know, tell the person next to you, God got you. If Peter was in the 21st century, he'd have said like that in that book. Commit your souls to Him who's a faithful creator, because God got you. But I give you the 21st version, conversion of Peter. God got you. No matter what your face, he said, commit your soul. Place something in the care of the world. Because God's hands big. God's hands huge. Are you hearing me, somebody? He holds the whole world in His hands. And that little thing that you're going through that you feel is a big thing, when you put it in God's hand, when God looks at it, it's very microscopic. In fact, right now I have a word for you. God looking at that thing that you think humongous, and God watching your challenge, and God telling you, that is a minor challenge. You watching that thing, and you magnify that problem. And it's looking big, but when you put it in God's hands, you see right now, it's looking big. Why? Because you're trying to fight up with it. If your husband gives you trouble, you know what to do? Put it in God's hands. Stop yap, 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 and not getting poor man. Estoy bien como la vez con mi foco. Shabalala, cachela, cachela. Touch para mi calo, touch my husband and pastor that church. No te que mi mamá ni Lord for the carnival. Somebody said, put it in God's hands. Make that deposit in the safekeeping. Are you with me? God's hands. His safety deposit box is safer than every account that you have where you have your money in the bank. When you put something in the God's hand, nothing can take it out. Are you hearing me, somebody? He says, commit your soul to Him in doing good. Who is of faith? He's reminding them, and I'll never do this alone. God is with you. I want to get you verse and close. Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 9. Just to confirm, because you see, sometimes you just forget who God is in these difficulties. Because why? The situation slamming against you. Are you with me? It hitting you left, right, and center, fire burning you. And sometimes you can't think straight. Peter is saying there is divine power, there is divine purpose, but there is divine presence. Deuteronomy, the Old Testament, God wanted the children of Israel to remember that He's a faithful God. And I want to remind you today as I get ready to close that God is faithful to you. Even when we are unfaithful, God remains faithful. Therefore, God says to Israel through Moses, know that the Lord your God, He is God. Look at that one. He is the faithful God who keeps covenant and mercy for 1,000 generations with those who love Him and keep His commandments. Let's go to the New Testament. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 9. God's faithfulness has a lot to do with His word, with His covenant. He's not like man who does break promise. Are you with me, somebody? When God made a promise, He's going to keep it. One of the promises that God made to you is, I will never leave you, nor I will forsake you. Even if you feel as though God is not there with you, I want you to know, you don't have to feel to know that God is not there with you. I want you to believe and know that God is with you. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 9, it says, the first few words of verse 9 of 1 Corinthians 1 is, God is faithful. That's about it. God is faithful. The first few words that Paul introduced to the church, he says, God, to remind them, and I reminded you in your time of difficulties, don't give up on God, amen. God is faithful, by whom you were called into the fellowship of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Give somebody a high ten. Tell them God is faithful. No matter what you're going through this morning, God will never leave you nor forsake you. Even when you feel as though God is not there, He's right there with you, holding your hands, carrying you through. 1 Corinthians 10 and verse 13. 1 Corinthians 10, and I can give you many more. There's so much scripture that identify and confirm. We forget sometimes that God is faithful. In 1 Corinthians 10, 13, it says, no temptation. That word temptation is the word trial. Someone is a trial. No temptation or trial has overtaken you except such as is common to a man. Meaning all of you going through something. We have this journey thing. As the pastor, I can't condemn and judge you. And I go through my thing myself. Is as such as is common to man. But what about this? But who? But God, in the midst of your trials, that thing that you can't bear, you don't understand, God is faithful, who will not allow you to be tempted above, beyond what you are able, but with the temptation will also make the way of escape that you might be able to bear. Tell the person next to you, because of God's faithfulness, tell them, because of God's faithfulness, you can bear it. And so I close this morning. And I want to encourage you this morning. We have learned to fight our fears, discourage our discouragement, weed out our worry. Today I want to release this prophetic word to you that you can stand firm through fiery trials. Let somebody stand firm. And so I encourage you, don't be surprised and rejoice according to Peter. It might be an oxymoron. But don't be surprised because you're such kingdoms. Satan is on your back. People don't like you. Are you with me? Life is hard. Why not be surprised? Why can I learn to rejoice? Why? Because you can draw upon divine power. Don't draw upon human power, your own power. Amen. Learn to draw upon divine power. Because Peter says the Spirit of God, of glory and of God, rests upon you. He says that when you go through difficulties, you are blessed. Meaning you are empowered. Not by yourself. You are empowered because of the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. You are empowered because of the Holy Spirit who lives inside of you. And you connect with divine power through prayer, through the reading of the word, through spending time with God and pouring your heart out to Him, and power is released. The greater your suffering, the greater the anointing. Can I amen, somebody? We learned today that you need to learn from your trials, because God have you in a school. He putting you through a test not to make you fail. That's not the kind of God we serve. He knows you can make it because He's going to help you. He's taking you through this because there is divine purpose. There is something He wants you to learn. Just as gold is purified and refined by fire. The impurities are burnt out. Are you with me? So too, amen, your fiery trials are like your faith is like gold. God is burning all the impurities in our life. He's taking things out. He's putting things in. He's making you bigger. He's making you better. He's making you greater. He's making you stronger. He's building character inside of you. Come on, somebody. Because there is divine purpose. Because God is in control. He's working behind the scenes. Because it is for His praise, His honor, and His glory. Can I get an amen? And then thirdly and finally, we learned today that you can stand for not only because of divine power, not only because of divine purpose, but He says that you must commit your soul to Him who is a faithful creator. Reminding them that God is faithful. No matter what you are going through, remember, God is faithful. Remember, God is always with you. If you can put it in your pipe and smoke it, then you'll be alright. You'll get through what you're going through. You'll overcome. You will conquer. Are you with me? You can even smile in the midst of a difficulty. Are you hearing me, somebody? What the enemy has meant for evil in your life today, God is going to turn it around and make it work for your good. What you see as a problem, there is possibility. What you see as adversity, there is opportunity. Are you hearing me, somebody? What you see as a curse, God will turn it around and make it into a blessing. What you see as a test, behind that test is a testimony. I want to encourage you to realize that there's an overcomer anointing upon you. And there's an ability of God, are you with me, to rise above and beyond. You may not get that situation removed, but God will make a way for you to pass. If you can lift your hands and give the Lord some praise, come on. Stand here, keep your feet.